Logos is able to quickly search thousands of resources for information relevant to a study task. This video will introduce some of those search capabilities and show the options available. Searches can run in a variety of modes through the search panel, accessed by clicking the search icon. The Bible search searches within Bibles. We're going to use search templates to help construct a search. Make the side panel wider if necessary. Select the template for a person and a biblical thing, enter Jesus in the person field, and select from the drop-down, and then river in the thing field, and select. This will return all verses where both Jesus and rivers are mentioned, even if not directly by name. To constrain the search range, click All Passages, and either select from a predefined range or enter one yourself. Choose John by typing it in, and then selecting the relevant entry from the drop-down. The only verse left is one that relates to our passage. Click it to open the preferred Bible to that verse. When you have constructed the search, you can close the template side panel if you wish. The Align view displays the search term in the center of the panel, while the Grid view provides the ability to search multiple versions at the same time. Change the search term to Cried from John 7:37, and switch from searching solely the ESV to Top Bibles by clicking the ESV, selecting it, and clicking the search icon on the right. This runs the search against your top 5 prioritized Bibles. Note that while the ESV has the word cried in verse 37, indicated by the filled-in cell, the NIV doesn't, indicated by the empty cell. To see the NIV rendering, either hover over the cell or click the column header to show that it uses Said in a Loud Voice instead. The analysis view is powerful, particularly for original language terms, but can take some time to run. Switch back to just the ESV and run a search for the Greek term pistuon from John 7:38. This is possible, as many English versions in Logos are tagged with the corresponding original language words, allowing you to search for these words without leaving the English version. The easiest way to enter the search is to use transliteration. Open the inline interlinear and look at the transliteration of the Greek term. To change which fields are shown, select from the inline interlinear menu. To enter a transliterated term in the search field, start with G colon, or H colon for Hebrew. Then, follow this with the letters P-I-S-T-E-U, and scroll down to select the lemma from the drop-down menu. Run the search and switch to analysis view. This shows the results presented in tabular form. Right-click on the header row to select different sets of information and add the sense column. To group results by one of the categories, such as sense, drag the column header to just above the header row. This shows results sorted by sense, displaying the different meanings behind the word. Pause the video for a few moments and explore the search feature in more detail. Instead of entering the search term manually, you can also do it directly from the biblical text by right-clicking the word. This invokes the context menu, which is a critical part of Logos software that we see in a number of contexts throughout these videos. Ensure the lemma is selected on the right, and then select Search This Resource on the left. This doesn't have the passage restriction, although we could add it in the same way as before so it shows where this word occurs, in its various senses, throughout the entire Bible. Right-click the arrow on the left of the results to bring up a range of options, and select Summary View, which makes it easier to look at each sense in turn. The basic search is for general searches in your library. You can use a search template to search for multiple terms such as water and spirit. Open the search template panel, select the Both Terms template, enter water in the first field and spirit in the second. Click the search button to run the search and return all articles that refer to both of these terms. Click one of the highlighted research results to open the resource in the correct place with the results highlighted. Search results can be viewed by their ranking, by resource name, or by the number of results. Why not stop the video for a few moments and see how these different views present different results? The media search is used to find relevant media, such as diagrams, maps, or art, and is covered in other Logos training videos. The clause search is powerful and is used to find specific terms, such as subjects, within their associated verbs within a clause. You can select other different clause tag sources to search by clicking the Greek New Testament link, but stay with the New Testament for this search. Enter subject colon Jesus and select Jesus from the dropdown. Click the search icon to show each instance of Jesus appearing as the subject of a clause. You can tighten the search by adding additional terms such as the verb. This presents a range of options for specifying the verb. Select the lemma and use the lemma translated as cried in John 7:37. Right-click the word, select lemma on the right, and then click copy on the left. Next, paste the lemma into the find box and select it from the drop-down. Now, run the search to find those clauses where Jesus is crying out. The morph search is used to find particular forms of words. We'll look at this in more detail in a later video. The syntax search is used to explore the detailed grammatical structure of a passage in an original language text. Searching is a powerful and sophisticated capability within Logos, with a number of different types and associated views. Together, they provide the ability to find the information you are looking for across your entire resource library. It's worth spending time experimenting with various options and thinking about how you can best use them in your study and research. The next video will show you how to make the most of your resources by using collections and link sets.